Good morning, students. Today we will discuss new type of progression, that is GP, geometrical progression. In the previous exercise, we have studied about the progression which was AP, arithmetic progression. Here we will discuss GP, geometrical progression. What is the difference between GP and AP? In AP, we always discuss about the difference of two consecutive terms. Always you are getting DC. When we will discuss about GP, in this case, we have to take the ratio of the terms. If the ratio of the terms, consecutive terms, is same, then you are having a progression which is GP. Suppose here it is written 2, 4, 8, 16. If you find the ratio of the terms A2 upon A1. What is it? 4 upon 2, that is 2. If you are getting A3 upon A2, it means 8 upon 4, you are getting 2. If A4 upon A3, you are getting 16 upon 8, that is 2. It means in each and every case, you are getting ratio of the consecutive term, that is same. If consecutive terms having the same ratio, then the GP, then the progression is known as the geometrical progression. I think you can now differentiate what is the difference between AP and GP. In the case of AP, we'll discuss only about the D difference. Here we are talking about the ratio. We are talking about the ratio of the consecutive terms. Here two other examples are also given: 1 upon 9, minus 1 upon 27, 1 upon 81, minus 1 upon 243. Find the ratio A2 upon A1, A3 upon A2, A4 upon A3. You will get the same ratio, that is equal to 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3. In the case of this one, third is also the example of the same ratio. It means these are the example of the sequences which are showing geometrical progression. In the geometrical progression, let's see what to do now further. In this geometrical progression, here it is a case when, yes, we will talk about few important words. First is what, how to write down the sequence A1, A2, A3, An. This is a way to write down the progression. But in the case of GP, as in a case of AP, we write always A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D. These are the terms. In the case of GP, you have to write down A, AR, AR square, AR cube, and up to so on. First term known as A, that is same as A is the first term. But at the place of D, we'll talk about only R. R is called the common ratio of the GP. Here it is written, R is called the common ratio of the GP. Common ratio in the progression above written, I have told you, all are showing the same ratio. So what? These above examples are the examples of GP. Last term, same as it is written as L, and N means number of terms. If you want to write down the ratio, you can write like this, AK plus 1 upon AK, that is the small r. Now, what is the formula, general term formula? General term formula is, here is written, general term formula, that is equal to, as in the case of AP, what was the formula? A plus N minus 1 into D. When you put N is equal to 1, 2, 3, and you will get that number of terms sequence wise. If you are asking about the what? GP general term. GP general term, that will be equal to AN is equal to AR to the power N minus 1. When you put here N is equal to 1, then you will get the first term. That will be 0. It means it is equal to A. If you put N is equal to 2, you will get 2 into, A into R to the power 2 minus 1, that is AR. What I have told you, sequence is A, AR, AR square, AR cube, and so on. So what general term will give you term when you put N value is equal to 1, 2, and any natural number. Okay, so it, here it is written AN will be equal to A to the A, R to the power N minus 1. When we'll talk about series, not about sequence, it means each and every term A, AR, AR square is joined with the sign, positive sign. So it is also series means A, A plus AR plus AR square plus and so on like this. This is representing the series. If terms are countable, it means it is finite. If terms are not countable, uncountable, it means what? Infinite geometrical series. In the case of sum, how to get the sum of the geometrical progression? Suppose Sn is equal to A, AR, AR square up to AR to the power N minus 1. Put R, first two cases are there. Put R is equal to 1. When R is equal to 1 means you are getting all R A's. Up to what? N terms. It means this is N into A. If N is, if R is not equal to 1, in that case, when you are multiplying by R to this statement, this first equation, so you will get R times of Sn. This is R times of Sn. A into R, AR square, AR cube, and up to AR to the power N. And subtract these two equations, first and second. First and second, subtract these two. You will get a formula of sum of geometrical progression. This is the formula of geometrical progression. Here is the formula. Rsn is equal to this one. When you are subtracting these two equations, you are getting 1 minus R into Sn is equal to A minus Ar to the power n. Take A common to the right hand side. That will be 1 minus R to the power n. You will get the formula Sn is equal to transpose this 1 minus R to the right hand side. You will get A into 1 minus R to the power n upon 1 minus R. If R is less than 1, if R is greater than 1, then you'll write down like this, A into R to the power N minus 1 upon R minus 1. Now, we'll discuss now few examples related to geometrical progression. First example, that is ninth example, find 10th and nth term of the GP 5, 25, 125. If you want 10th term, just discuss 10th term. General term is what? General term is AN AR to the power N minus 1. When you want 10th term, it means at the place of N, you have to put N is equal to 10. So what? A10 will be equal to AR to the power 9. Now you can learn this pattern. If you are asking about A10, it means AR to the power 9. If you are asking about A12, it means AR to the power 11. Like this. Okay. Now you want A. What is A and what is R? Put the value of A and R. If GP is given to you, it means first term is what? A. And ratio 25/5. That is equal to R. It means A is equal to 5 and R is also equal to 5. Put the value of A here. 5 into 5 to the power 9, that comes out 5 to the power 10. When you want nth term means at the place of N, you have to put N as it is. And at the place of A, you have to put 5. At the place of R, you have to put 5. It means 5 into 5 to the power n minus 1, you are getting 5 to the power n minus n. Because 5 to the power 1 plus n minus 1, you will get what? 5 to the power n. Now you can do this example 9. Now come to the example number 10. In example number 10, GP is given to you, that is 2832. Which term is 131,072? You have to just find out which term is this one. Suppose it is AN, that is 131,072. Now you have to find out the value of N, it means. Find N. Here, what is A? First term that is given to you, that is 2. What is R? Ratio 8 upon 2, that is 4. Now, it means when you replace this AN by its formula, that is what? A R to the power N minus 1, that is equal to 1372. Now, A and R, A is 2. R is 4. 4 to the power N minus 1. These are in multiplication. Equal to 131072. Now, shift this 2 to the right hand side. What you will get? You will get 4 to the power n minus 1 is equal to, divided by 2, it means 65536. Now you have to now check how much power of 4 is equal to 65536. You can find it is 4 to the power n minus 1 will equal to 4 to the power 8. Now bases are same. If bases are same, then power should be equal. And value of n will be equal to 9. Now you can do the question. Now next question. Now example number 11. For the example number 11, what you have to do? GP having third term equal to 24. It means A3 is equal to 24. Sixth term, A6 is equal to 192. You have to find out 10th term. Now, A3 means what? AR to the power 2. And AR to the power 5 is given 192. In the binomial chapter, I have told you when you solve two equations in up to class 10, you always try to add and subtract the equations, you will get the value of variable. In the case, you never tried to divide two equations to get the value of the variable. In class 11th, in binomial, we did question regarding this. Now here, same concept will be applied here. When you divide these two equation, AR to the power 5, by AR to the power 2, you will get 192 upon 24. AR cancelled and R powers are subtracted because 5 same base power should be subtracted. R to the power 3, what it will be equal to? R to the power 3 will be equal to, simplify it, what you will get? 8. So what? R to the power 3 will be equal to 2 to the power 3. Now here, powers are equal, then bases should be equal. It means the value of R will be equal to 2. If R is 2, then you can calculate the value of A. Put the value of R in any of the equation. You will get the value of A. A will be equal to 6. Put the value of R here, you will get 6. 4, 4, 6 is 24, and A will be equal to 6. Now, your requirement is to find the value of A10. It means AR to the power 9. Now, you know the value of A, that is, what is A? 6. And what is the value of R? R is equal to 2. Put these two values and you will get the value of A10. Okay. Now, example number 12. In example number 12, find the sum of n terms and the sum of 5 terms of the geometrical series this. Here you want to find out the sum of 5 terms and sum of n terms. First we will find the sum of n terms. at the end, we'll put n is equal to 5, you will get the sum of n, 5 terms. A is 1, first term is 1. Ratio 2 upon 3 divided by 1, you are getting same 2 upon 3. Ratio is 2 upon 3. And the formula to get the sum, when the r is less than 1, then that is a into 1 minus r to the power n upon 1 minus r. Put the value of r and a, you are getting this 3 simplification, 3 into 1 minus 2 upon 3 whole power n. Now the next part of this question is sum up to 5 terms. It means in this solution, you have to put n is equal to 5. When you put n is equal to 5, you will get 211 upon 81. Now you can do the question. Now next question is, next question is, we'll do example number 15. 13. Next page will be at the end. Example 13, you will do here on how many terms you can find by using this GP. How many terms means you have to get the value of n in the previous question. When you solve, I think you can solve it, you have done it in class 10th also, how to use the power to solve the question. I think we'll try this example number 14 here on. Okay, example number 13, you can do your own. We will do now example number 14. Example number 14. Example number 14, the sum of the first three terms of a GP is 13 upon 12 and their product is minus 1. Find the common ratio and the terms. In the AP, when you have to choose three consecutive AP terms, then you take three fixed terms. Same as in the GP, where you want three terms which are in GP, then you have to take the terms A upon R, A and AR. In AP, you take A minus D, A and A plus D. Here, you will take A upon R, A and AR. When you take such type of pattern, then you will get the answer easily. Otherwise, if you take A, AR, AR square, then this becomes difficult one to solve the question. That's why this pattern is fixed. When you want three terms in the GP, then you have to take A upon R, A and AR. Sum of the terms is given to you, that is 13 upon 12, and product of the terms is given minus 1. Sum is written here. Now product, in the case of product, when you multiply them, R is cancelled by R, you are getting A cube is equal to minus 1. A cube is equal to minus 1 means, minus 1 can be written as like this. So what? Powers are equal, then basis will be equal to A is equal to minus 1. If A is equal to minus 1, put here A is equal to minus 1. When you put A is equal to minus 1 here, you will get the quadratic, that is quadratic 12R square plus 25R plus 12 equal to 0. I think you can simplify the quadratic. From here, you will get the value of R, two values of R. If two values are of R, you will get, it means corresponding to first R, you have to take A is equal to minus 1, you will get three terms. Corresponding to second R, you will take again A is equal to minus 1 along with this second R. You will get second group of the terms A upon R, A and AR. I think solve this question. You are on now further.
मुझे कुछ बच्चे करने भी I think you can do the question. Here is the value. Yes, you will get the value of r is equal to minus 3 by 4 and minus 4 by 3. When you put this r is equal to minus 3 by 4 along with the value of a, that is minus 1, you will get the first group of the answer. When you put r is equal to minus 4 by 3 and along with this a is equal to minus 1, in both cases you have to take a is equal to minus 1. Then both second group will be there to get for the answer. Two groups answer will be there in the question. Now for the next example, example number 15, one pattern is given to you. Sequence pattern is 777, 777 and 7777 and so on. In such type of questions, suppose it is 555 like this, 666, 666 like this. In this pattern, you have to do the question like this question, this example. You have to just remember it, how to proceed the question. In this question, Sn, you have to find out sum of n terms of this given sequence. It is written Sn is equal to 7 plus 77, 7 plus 77 plus 777 and so on. First step, you have to take common 7. If there is 6, then you have to take common 6. If there is 5, then you have to take common 5 and so on. Here, when you take 7 common, let's do it. When you take common 7 from the statement, you will get 1 plus 11 plus 111 and so on up to n terms. This is the second step. In the next step, you have to do what? Multiplying and dividing by 9. Divided by 9 is outside, and when you are multiplying by 9 inside, you will get like this, n terms. Okay. If it is 5, 6, any other number, same process you have to apply. First take that number common, then multiplying by 9. In every question, you have to do this multiplying and dividing by 9. Now, here is the way 7 upon 9 will be as it is. Now, this 9 can be written as what? 10 minus 1. 99 means, that is 1 less than 100. It means 10 square minus 1. 999 is what? 10 cube minus 1 and up to n terms. Now collect the terms. Now collect the terms which are having power 10. 10, 10 square, 10 cube. It means what? 7 upon 9 is outside. 10 plus 10 square plus 10 cube up to n terms. This is the first group. And minus of sign taking common from minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Collect these terms. Minus sign taking common, 1 plus 1 plus 1 up to n terms. It means what? This becomes what? 1 is written n times, it becomes n. It means minus of n is the statement, this one. For this, what to do to solve this question, this part? 10, 10 square, 10 cube and so on. What is this? When you divide second by first term, third by second term, you are getting the same ratio. It means this is an GP. And apply the formula of GP here, some formula of GP. Let's see how to do. Yes. This is what? 7 upon 9 into 10 into 10 to the power n minus 1 upon 10 minus 1. This is what? GP formula. A r to the power n minus 1 upon r minus 1. And I have told you this becomes n minus of n. And this is the answer. Example number 16. Example number 16. A person has two parents, four grandparents, eight great grandparents and so on. Find the number of his ancestors during the 10 generations preceding his on. It means sequence is what? 2, 4, 8. As you see here, when you take the ratio, you are getting what? Same ratio. It means this is a GP. So R is 2, A is 2, N is equal to what? How much generation? Up to generation 10, you have to calculate. It means N is equal to 10. So up to 10th generation, how many are there? It means S of 10. You can calculate by putting the value of A and R. Okay. Now for the geometrical mean. In the geometrical mean, we will do further next topic. In this topic, we will discuss about the geometrical mean. Geometrical mean and geometrical ratios. Okay. In this, we will discuss about geometrical mean of the two numbers. As we have discussed about arithmetical mean of two numbers, that is, arithmetical mean means what? A plus B upon 2. A upon B plus 2. And geometrical mean, that is root of product of AB. That is geometrical mean. Yes, here is the concept. We'll discuss about it now. Yes. In arithmetic mean, we have write A plus B by 2. Now for the geometrical mean of two numbers, A and B, that is equal to under the root AB. If two numbers are given to you, you want to find out geometrical mean. It means square root of product of A and B is known as the geometrical mean. Now, if you are inserting n geometrical means between A and B, then what is the value of R? It means total n terms are inserted. A and B are already there. Total number of terms will be n plus 2 terms. It means B will be equal to what? As general formula is, An is equal to AR to the power n minus 1. If it is An plus 2, it means what? This will be equal to AR to the power n plus 2 minus 1. AR to the power n plus 1. This is written here. Then B will be equal to, last term is B. It means An is B. B will be equal to AR to the power n plus 1. From here, you can calculate the value of R. How you will calculate? B upon A is equal to R plus 1. If you want to eliminate this n plus 1 power, it means take 1 upon n plus 1 power both side. It means B upon A whole power 1 upon n plus 1 R to the power 1. It becomes R to the power 1, or you can say R. R is equal to B upon A whole power 1 upon n plus 1. Now we'll apply the process here now for the example number 17. First term is given 1, second term is 256. You have to insert 3 terms in between this. It means 1 geometrical mean first, geometrical mean second, geometrical mean third, and this is 256. So what number of terms will be what? 5. Total number of terms will be equal to 5. It means A5 is equal to 256. And what is A5? AR to the power 4, that is equal to 256. What is the value of A? That is 1. It means R to the power 4 will be equal to 256. And here you can calculate the value of R. If you'll get the value of R, it means G1 will be equal to what? G1 will be equal to AR. G2 will be equal to AR square. G3 will be equal to AR cube. Now you can see solution further. Yes, you can find here the value of R, that is equal to 4, and G1, G2, G3 you can calculate geometrical means, that those are minus 4, 16 and minus 64, and it means inserted terms are 4, 16 and 64, between 1 and 256. So that are the resulting sequences of the GP. Now, relationship between arithmetical mean and geometrical mean. You have to remember it. Arithmetical mean is always greater than geometrical mean or either equal to geometrical mean. It never be less than geometrical mean. It means what? Arithmetical mean, let's solve it. Solve the question. Arithmetical mean is a plus b by 2. Geometrical mean is root ab. And relation, this you have to remember. Arithmetical mean is always greater than or equal to geometrical mean. Now, in the example number 18, the relationship between a and m are given to you. That is what? If am and gm of two positive numbers are 10 and 8, it means arithmetic mean is given to you. Let's do this question. Arithmetic mean is given to you 10. It means AM is given to you 10. And geometrical mean is given 8. Arithmetical mean of two numbers means A plus B upon 2 is given 10. Geometrical mean means root AB is equal to 8. You can write it like this, a plus b will be equal to 20, and here you can write ab is equal to 8 square means 64, squaring both sides. Two equations are here. Now you can do the question by putting the value. This is the first equation, this is the second equation. Now here in this question, I can put the values. Suppose b is equal to 20 minus a, I have taken from the first equation and put in the equation number second. What you will get? A into 20 minus A is equal to 64. Here I have put the value of B. That is equal to 20 minus A. Now this becomes 20A minus A square is equal to 64. Or you can say it is A square minus 20A plus 64 is equal to 0. Now this is a quadratic. You can solve this quadratic. You will get the value of A. And those value of A you can put here in the equation B is equal to 20 minus A, you will get the value of B. So you can solve the question or example number 18. Now try exercise 9.3. Do these examples in your notebook also. And try questions of 9.3. We'll discuss in next lecture few important questions of exercise 9.3. Thank you. Have a nice day.